Hello everyone, welcome to Easy Engineering Classes. We are continuing with our preparation series for GATE and UGC NET computer science papers and solving previous year questions. So today we'll solve two questions of theory of computation. The first question is, identify the language generated by the following grammar where S is the start symbol. This is the grammar that has been given to you and the options are provided. As you can see, both of these questions came in GATE 2017 paper. Now, starting with this question, since S is the start symbol and X and Y are the strings or are the non-terminals that will form the string. So, if in this case X or Y, any of them is empty, then the string will only be formed by the other non-terminal. So, since it is given that Y is can also be epsilon or it can also be lambda, you can say, then in that case the string will only be formed by X. Alright, so now X says that X can be replaced by AX or A, which means X basically is representing A plus a single A or more than one A, because either X would be replaced by a single A or a single A followed by more number of X, and more number of X means more number of A. So basically we can write that X denotes A to the power of M. Here M is any variable, that means A any number of times, such that M has to be greater than or equal to 1. Because if X is replaced by a single A, it will be equal to 1, else if A it is replaced by AX, then it will be greater than 1. Now coming to Y, Y denotes A, Y, B or epsilon. Alright, in this case, Y would always be replaced by A, Y and B, and this Y would again be replaced by A, Y and B and so on. And if you see here, the string that would be formed by Y would be some number of A's and then followed by the equal number of B's, because every time an A is occurring, it is being followed by a B, and when we have to terminate this string, we'll replace Y with an epsilon or empty symbol. Alright, so in this case, the string or the kind of string that would be represented by Y would be A raised to power n, that means some number of A's followed by the equal number of B's, such that n is equal to 0. If we replace Y with the empty string, then n will be equal to 0 or it is greater than 0. So since S is forming this language and it is being formed by XY, so we can say it is being formed by A to the power of M, such that M is greater than equal to 1, followed by A to the power N, B to the power N, such that N is greater than equal to 0. So obviously the final result or the language that would be formed would look like A raised to the power M. Yeah, that means M number of times A followed by N number of times B, such that M is greater than N, because here M represents the sum of this M and N. Alright, so let me write it as M dash, and this is M dash, where M dash is equal to M plus N and N dash is equal to N. Alright, where M dash is greater than N dash and N is greater than equal to 0. So now let's check which answer or which option is correct. A M times B N times M greater than equal to N. No, M greater than equal to N, not this option. Now this option says M greater than N, such that N is greater than equal to 0, which is exactly matching our answer. So this is how you can find out what language is represented or generated by the given grammar. Now coming to the second question, the minimum possible number of states of a deterministic finite automata that accepts the given regular language. and the language has been given to you such that W1 and W2 are strings formed by the set A, B star. That means any number of occurrences of A and B in any order, and the length of W1 is equal to 2 exactly, and W2 has to be at least, the length of W2 has to be at least 3 or greater than 3. So we can say that both W1 and W2 are formed by this string or by this set A or B occurring any number of times. So simplifying the language, we can write down the language as, since it is saying exactly 2 occurrence of W1, so A or B followed by A or B. So either a single A or B would be selected from this bracket and followed by another A or another B from this bracket. So the length of W1, this is representing W1, would be 2. Then W1 is followed by an A in the language, then W2, and the length of W2 is 3, at least 3. So A or B, and this is the minimum. There can be more number of A's and B. So we'll put a star here. Why a star and not a plus? Because there may or may not be more number of A's and B. So this forms W2. So W1A, W2 is the language that would be formed, and the minimal DFA that would be formed by this language would be starting with state Q0. I would go to state Q1 with A, B. That means a single character of W1, then A, B, the second character of W2, then followed by an A. The B would lead to a dead state here. So this is a dead state. Please don't forget to mention the or write the dead state while making the minimal DFA also. Then followed by state Q3, then A, B, Q4, A, B, Q5, A, B, Q6, and finally this would lead to a final state, Q7, be a final state, and in this more A and B's may or may not occur. So the number of states would be 8 in the minimal DFA. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Dead states are generally not counted, but you have to draw it in case it is asked, and it is also said in the question that considering the dead states as well. So don't forget to draw the dead states and read the question properly. So that was all for today's lecture. I hope you understood both the questions. Please subscribe to the channel of Easy Engineering Classes for more such lectures on GATE and UGC computer science related previous year question papers. Thank you for watching the video.